This video is going to look at the three situations where your derivative does not exist. And the first one is if your graph contains a discontinuity. Which this one's typically be fairly straightforward. For example, if you look at your graph, you're going to have some type of a break in the graph. And this would be one particular example here. Where your derivative does not exist because here you have a discontinuity. Now, be aware the derivative does not exist at the point here at zero, but your derivative does exist other places on the graph. So in other words, your derivative is not going to exist at the actual discontinuity. The second situation is if a graph has a sharp turn. Now, what do we mean when we talk about the graph having a sharp turn? Well, basically that means if you look at the graph, it's going to look like your absolute value where you have like a sharp V. At this point, at this sharp turn, your graph will not have a derivative. The derivative does not exist. And let me redraw this here. This may look a little better if I move the absolute value over here, for example. So therefore, the derivative does not exist at this point. Now, your derivative would exist at other points in the graph, just not at the sharp turn. And that's because if you look at the derivative from the left, hopefully it's obvious here, if we look at the derivative from the left side, your derivative is going to be negative, and if we were to look at the derivative from the right, it's going to be positive. So here, you're from the left and from the right, your derivatives are not equal, and also there is no tangent line. So therefore, if you have a sharp turn in the graph, your derivative does not exist. And the third situation is if you have a graph with a vertical tangent line. And an example of this would be here. If your graph looks, let's say, something like this, and then at this particular point, we'll say here, your tangent line is vertical, which we know that if you have a vertical tangent line, your slope is undefined. So therefore, if it's undefined, that means we cannot have a derivative at that point. So once again, the three places you want to be concerned with your derivative not existing is if you have a discontinuity where there's a break in the graph, or if your graph has a sharp turn, which is this sharp V shape. So your derivative does not exist at this point. And the third case is if your vertical line is, if your tangent line is vertical, because therefore it is undefined. And there's a couple statements I want to make here that you need to be careful with. And the first one is, if your function f has a derivative at, we'll say, some x value where x is equal to c, then f is continuous at x equals c. So if f has a derivative at x equals c, then f is also continuous at x equals c. Now, based on that statement, can we also make this statement, or what do you think about this one? If f is continuous at x equals c, then does that mean f has a derivative? Well, if you're not careful, you'll make a mistake here. Just because your function is continuous, then based on the example above, we can say f may or may not be differentiable. And differentiable just is a fancy word saying that whether you can take the derivative or not. If it's differentiable, we can take the derivative. So here we're saying if the function is continuous at c, then f may or may not be differentiable at x equals c. Okay? And we can state that because up here, if we look at the second case and even the third case, our function is continuous here at the point C or here at this blue dot, but what about the derivative? The derivative is not defined. So therefore, the function is not differentiable at that point. For an example, if I gave you the graph of a function that looked, let's say, similar to this here, where the function is x squared over x squared minus 4, and our graph is going to look something like this here. You're going to notice, based on the function, you can even tell here, you're going to notice that we're going to have a vertical asymptote at 2 and negative 2, and there's also going to be a horizontal asymptote at 1, and your graph is going to end up looking similar to this here. And the question is, at what values is this function not differentiable? And based on the examples above, I hope it's obvious that here this function is not differentiable at x equals positive or negative 2. And the reason it's not differentiable here at negative 2 and positive 2, clearly there's a discontinuity, there's a break in the graph.